Folks, you have to ask yourself, does a speech make foreign policy? Well, the Obama administration thinks that making speeches is foreign policy. Making speeches is domestic policy. It really doesn't work that way, but right now he's going to make a bunch of speeches defending his foreign policy against critics who say he's been weak and he's giving up America's leadership in the world.
The president is making his case a day after he announced the United States pullout from Afghanistan. Gary Lane has the story.
President Obama laid out his plans for the Afghanistan troop drawdown at the White House Tuesday.
America's combat mission will be over by the end of this year. Starting next year, Afghans will be fully responsible for securing their country. American personnel will be in an advisory role. We will no longer patrol Afghan cities or towns, mountains or valleys. That is a task for the Afghan people.
America's 32,000 troops will be reduced to 9,800 by the end of this year. 5,000 will remain at the end of 2015. And only embassy guards will be present just before President Obama leaves office. The drawdown of troops to 9,800 by the end of this year is at the upper end of what U.S. generals have said is required to assist the Afghans. Meanwhile, the president is outlining a foreign policy vision for his remaining years in office. And during today's commencement address at West Point, it includes his view that American power is only part of a sustainable international system. Critics say U.S. foreign policy has lacked strong leadership and strategic thinking. They cite presidential indecisiveness in Syria and America's inability to prevent Russian annexation of Crimea. White House advisors held a series of briefings for members of Congress to address foreign policy concerns. A Republican senator reportedly called one of the meetings bizarre because specific questions were never answered. Tennessee Senator Bob Corker summed up his view of U.S. foreign policy, saying, quote, "One of the problems with the White House is that they view speeches as foreign policy. They don't really follow through with much in the way of substance. It's always minimal." But for now, the emphasis is on Afghanistan, America's longest-running war, one that President Obama inherited, one that he's determined to end, at least for the United States of America.
We have to recognize Afghanistan will not be a perfect place, and it is not America's responsibility to make it one.
Gary Lane, CBN News.
The problem in Iraq was that the president pulled out before there was a status of forces agreement, and therefore the country has devolved into chaos. We hope that doesn't happen in Afghanistan. They just had an election. Millions of the Afghan people came out to vote, which is rather extraordinary. Karzai, who's not exactly our friend, has refused to sign any kind of deal with America bringing our forces on. And I, like so many Americans, would be glad to get rid of that place. It's just been a nightmare. But at the same time, we've invested treasure and blood in that awful region. And to turn it back over to the Taliban, turn it back over to Al-Qaeda would be a mistake. And that's what people are concerned about. Well, here at home, there's another scandal, and it's one of those things that these bureaucrats are trying to hide what they're doing from the American people, and it's health care at the Veterans Administration. I think that guy who's in charge of it, General Shinseki, was probably a pretty good guy in the Army, and I think he's taking the blame for all of it, but nevertheless, he's probably going to have to go, but a whole lot of others need to go with him. John Jessup has that story.
Pat, new revelations on how VA clinics used tricks to hide delays in treating veterans. Some clinics made fake appointments, kept unofficial logs, and scheduled visits without telling the patient. The, quote, gaming strategies were used to make it seem like veterans were getting appointments within the goals for time set by the Veterans Affairs Department. And in Colorado, 500,000 veterans are still waiting for a hospital promised to them 10 years ago.
Kept our word. We served honorably. And let me turn.
I don't hate the VA. They got some of the greatest employees that give caregivers in the world. But their management, they got to change.
The building project is $500 million over budget, and 16 contractors are suing because the VA isn't paying them. Meanwhile, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel has ordered a 90-day review of the military health care system. A pregnant woman was stoned to death by her own family outside a courtroom in Pakistan. Farzana Parveen's father called her murder an honor killing because she married someone without her family's consent. Nearly 20 people attacked the 25-year-old and her husband in broad daylight, including her father, brothers, and her cousin, who was the man her father wanted her to marry. The Human Rights Commission of Pakistan reports that 869 women were murdered in honor killings last year. Pat?
You know, I spent a little time in Pakistan on two occasions, and I found a country that had been a military trained by the British and extremely civilized and extremely aware of life. And to see that country devolve into chaos the way it is, it's just amazing. They're surrendering to the extremist Muslim group. And this honor killing thing, to stone a girl to death because she married the wrong man? Imagine that in America. Just some of you feminists, why don't you start yelling about what's happening to those Muslim women? The plight of women under Islam is appalling. And it's not some extreme sect that is at the root of that system. John?
Pat, pilots may only have to think to fly in the future. Researchers at a German university gave 7 test subjects special caps to wear. They were equipped with electrodes that could read electrical signals from the brain. Those signals were translated into computer commands. CNET.com reports that all 7 were able to fly a plane in a flight simulator, even though they weren't all pilots. One person had no experience in the cockpit, but all of them flew well enough in the simulator to meet some of the standards for getting a pilot's license. Pat, for all the wonders of modern technology, I think I prefer the good old-fashioned way.
Well, I'm not sure. I have a private pilot's license. I went through all the things where you have to solo. You're scared to death. The instructor gets out and says, it's all yours, and you take off, and that thing's going up in the air. And you have to fly hour after hour after hour, and then you learn how to do instruments, and you do all this. Man, if they could do an electrode to your brain and bring you up to speed in a few hours, hey, that is cool. John?
Well, Pat, for those who prefer ground travel, someday you may not have to drive a car because it will be driving itself. Internet giant Google is building a self-driving car without a steering wheel. Google has already tested some cars with a combination of sensors and computers. The company doesn't plan to make the cars itself. Instead, it will work with other businesses. Google hopes to have 100 prototypes later this year or early next year. Well, exercise pays off for everyone, even if you're older. A new study found that older people who walked and did some basic strength exercises every day have a better chance of staying mobile and not ending up physically disabled. The study is being published in the Journal of American Medical Association. It involved people from 70 to 89 years old, and many of them started the study, had health problems like diabetes and high blood pressure or previous heart attacks and strokes. The researchers emphasized that the exercises were simple and can be done anywhere and in any environment. And Pat, I guess we'll just have to check to see if that report includes horse riding.
Well, it has to. It has to. And I'm planning, I'm going to do a little exercises with a horse, I think Monday, and I'll see if we can get a camera out there to show you what it looks like for an old guy riding a horse in Grand Prix dressage. It looks good.
It's a serious workout. People don't realize it.
Well, when you've got a 1,600-pound animal doing what he wants to do, and you've got to do what you want to do on top of it, it gets to be fun. But I do lift weights, too. I think it's important. Do you lift weights?
I lift weights, and, of course, I love to hike. I didn't get to hike this weekend, but I did a lot of walking. My sister and I did a lot of walking.
Walking is fabulous. Okay.
Power walking.
Wow.
Phil Robertson, the star of Duck Dynasty, will speak to a Republican group in New Orleans Thursday. Robertson will address the Republican Leadership Conference along with other notable figures, including Republican National Committee Chairman Reince Priebus, former presidential candidate Newt Gingrich, Donald Trump, as well as some Republican senators. An atheist group has lost its lawsuit challenging tax exemptions for churches and religious groups. A federal judge in Kentucky dismissed the suit from American Atheist, a group from New Jersey. It sued the IRS in a Kentucky federal court last year, saying that tax-exempt status given to religious organizations is discriminatory and should be ruled unconstitutional. But the judge found the regulations for tax-exempt organizations don't favor any group over another. American Atheists plans to appeal. Well, you can always get the latest from CBN News by going to our website at cbnnews.com.